Xi Jinping is nervous. He is jittery. His legs are trembling. The color on his face has vanished, and he is making some desperate moves to stop his greatest fears from becoming a reality. Who did this to Xi Jinping? The supreme leader of the communist-ruled China, the face of the paper dragon who rules with an iron fist, the wolf warrior who gives zero care for the Chinese people. Now he's turned pale as a ghost. Who did this to him? Well, it was Modi. And all Modi did was say happy birthday. That was enough to set off alarms at the CCP headquarters. Hi, and welcome to TFI Global, the foreign affairs and geopolitical analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I am your host Shubhangi, and in this video, I will tell you about China smashing the panic button after PM Modi's subtle hints. On Wednesday, CCP General Secretary Xi Jinping tried to rattle India. In his first visit to Tibet after taking over as China's president, Xi Jinping visited a town called Nyingchi, a strategically located border town close to the Indian state of Arunachal Pradesh. Xi Jinping came as close as 15 kilometers to the effective Indo-Tibetan border. The visit by Xi Jinping came in the backdrop of Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his ministers publicly wishing the Dalai Lama a happy birthday. The 14th Dalai Lama, who has taken refuge in India, is considered a separatist by China. He is the spiritual leader of Tibet, who is now the face of the Tibetan independence movement. Tensions are soaring between India and China. India has just fortified its border with Tibet. India has redirected at least 50,000 additional troops to its border with China. India currently has around 200,000 troops focused on the border, a rise of more than 40% from 2020. Interestingly, China claims Arunachal Pradesh, which is a sovereign Indian territory, as South Tibet. India completely rejects such assertions, and Xi Jinping making a visit to Nyingchi shows how the CCP is looking to heighten tensions with India on a new front towards the east. This comes as India made some serious moves in the Ladakh region. In recent news, to counter China on the Himalayan border, an aggressive India under Prime Minister Narendra Modi is gearing up to build 4 new airports and 37 helipads across the Union Territory of Ladakh, which is currently a hotspot of military tensions between India and China. When it does, China will be facing the possibility of war on two fronts, with India on one side and Japan on the other. A war with Japan also means a war with the United States. Therefore, China is in no position to win any major conflict in the future. And this is why Xi Jinping is even more riled up. So, with an eye on Tibet, where the Chinese Communist Party and the People's Liberation Army are despised, Xi Jinping is now pushing the Chinese military to establish ties with the people in order to reap benefits out of the same. According to a report by the South China Morning Post, China has for the first time detailed the military's responsibility to strengthen its bonds with the public to win wars. According to state news agency Xinhua, the provision for the military on works for the Chinese people defines the status, guiding principles, and basic tasks of the process, laying out key points and the regulatory requirements for the military. The provision released by the Central Military Commission recently will take effect from August the 1st, and it says the provision centers on building a flesh and blood relationship between the Chinese military and the Chinese people, improving the basis for the military to win wars and consolidating and developing unity between the two sides. Therefore, China is pushing for the PLA to mend its broken ties with the people of Tibet, who it calls Chinese. However, the PLA won't exactly seek to foster its ties with Tibetans by laughing and sharing meals with them. It is very likely that the PLA will force itself upon Tibetans and make them help the CCP's armed agents under duress. The Chinese have historically never shied away from subjugating Tibetans and molesting their human rights. In fact, the Xinjiang model is slowly being adopted in Tibet as well. And the new military provision coming into effect next month will be a big step forward at completely brutalizing Tibetans. The Chinese administration is already committing unspeakable atrocities against Uyghur Muslims as it has effectively turned Xinjiang into a prison. Experts believe that China has deployed over 1 million spies to keep an eye on Uyghurs, as their atrocities know no bounds and have blurred the lines between public and private lives. Since 2018, Uyghur Muslims in Xinjiang have to mandatorily invite government officials into their homes, provide them information about their lives and political views, and comply with blatant political indoctrination. The Chinese administration is trying to ethnically cleanse Xinjiang by practicing the Pair Up and Become Family program, which involves the country's Han ethnic majority officers to stay in Uyghur households every 2 months. The Chinese government describes the spies as relatives of the monitored families who have to work, eat, and often share a bed with their hosts, as the Uyghurs are compulsorily made to stay with their paired relatives day and night. Since the male members of Uyghur families have been detained in Chinese detention centers, the communist officials effectively sleep with Uyghur women as part of their supposed Pair Up and Become Family program. Now, the Central Military Commission of China, led by Xi Jinping, has given the go-ahead for the same to be emulated in Tibet as well. According to well-known Chinese scholar Adrian Zenzi's finding, which has also been corroborated by news agency Reuters, Tibet is fast becoming the next Xinjiang. Xi Jinping has wanted to make Tibet an impregnable fortress, and China is replicating the Xinjiang model in Tibet with the establishment of mass internment camps. Reported by TFI earlier, the Chinese Communist Party has rolled out what many believe is a large-scale coercive program to enroll Tibetans as forced labor or workers who are made to unwillingly leave their households to work for Chinese industries as cheap labor. The Chinese Communist Party considers Tibetans as uncultured, lazy, and dirty people who are not willing to work for the greater good of China. In fact, policy documents call for effectively eliminating quote-unquote lazy people in the province. The training centers also witness military-style training of Tibetans who are indoctrinated forcefully with Chinese communist propaganda. Xi Jinping is already at war with the Uyghurs and Tibetans, and a country which is at war domestically cannot win conflicts with other nations, especially when the nation in question is India, which knows better than anyone else when and how to play the Tibet card. China is strengthening its positions in Tibet with the aim of taking on India, while being acutely aware of the fact that India can very well give rise to a popular uprising in Tibet against the CCP whenever it wants. With Xi Jinping's nervousness peaking, things are about to get very interesting.